Hey guys, we are out from the second time for the show Tenet by Christopher Nolan. If you don't know who Christopher Nolan is, he's the guy who made Interstellar, Dark Knight, the Dark Knight Rises, Batman Begins. What other movies did he make?
Interstellar, Memento.
Basically, he's the kind of guy who's really good at cinematography, and it shows here. So it has really good music, really good sound effects, really good camera angles. It does, the camera does move a lot though. So it gives you a bit of dizziness if you think the camera here is shaky. That one is shaky. If you look at the camera a bit, you will get nauseous. So that's just a warning. But I previously did a review of Tenet. And I gave it like, I think it's 6 over 10. Yeah. But now, I would say it's a 7 over 10 because when I first watched it, I felt like walking out. It was Dunkirk. The other movie that Christopher Nolan did was Dunkirk. Yeah, it has a very like intense feel to it, like, during a war. So you get that he doesn't build the character up as much. Just as in Tenet, but with Tenet, there is a sort of a redemption to it when you watch more than once, because it's a movie that goes back in time. So basically, you get a character build up towards the end of this movie, and you understand more about it. So the second time you watch, you will understand that halfway through the movie, it's actually a pincer or temporal effect of time going backward. So halfway through is actually like time going backward, and the first part is like time going forward. But I think he didn't do such a good job at explaining the time.
Yeah, exactly.
If you don't know which part is going backward and which part is going forward, so it's really confusing if you just watch it one time. So you have to keep that in mind. So if you're just watching the first time, you're gonna get a headache. So what do you want to say?
Second time makes a lot more sense. But now you tend to see it in a straightforward manner. Mm-hmm. You have the slight British snobbery and bespoke suits. You have the evil Russian oligarch, the damsel in distress, and you have the hero and his what you call it? I wouldn't say sidekick.
Apprentice.
Yeah, not more an apprentice, like bro. He's like bro.
So that's acted by Robert Pattinson, our upcoming Batman.
Yep. So it's a prelude for his Batman, and I would say what do you think about the fight scene? The action, the visual effects. It's okay, it's quite acceptable, right?
Practical effect, you can see that they don't spend much, guys. Of course, because practical effect is expensive.
But it's believable.
Yeah, so this is Rashman here.
They actually crash a plane there. It's a real plane. It looks like it's believable.
It's actually a plane, but you don't see it's like flame going through the building and then the fire comes out. That's all.
Because it's going back in time. So it's a bit confusing when you first watch it. You don't understand the concept.
Yeah.
Basically, it's like a science fiction temporal abnormality. So something that I think Einstein talked about, temporal or rather time dilation. So time can actually go at different speed depending on the mass of an object. So for example, if you are near a big object like an Earth, it has a strong gravity, then time actually slows down. And you go to a black hole, time really, really slows down to a point where you actually go back in time. So Christopher Nolan already explained that concept in Interstellar. You can actually go back in time. But over here in this Tenet, you are actually creating like something like a Stargate machine, which is a time machine that goes back in time and creates pockets of time. So you get special effects bullets going backwards, like bullet time. But to me, that doesn't really make sense, because for every object, there needs to be a source of the action, or rather an actor, right? So how does the bullet go backwards?
I don't know. You have to see it with the intention of being entertained, not really but it is a good entertainment if you watch it twice.
Because if you try to make sense, everything doesn't make sense.
Yeah, it actually connects. It just connects the dots to see it the second time. Yeah.
I just focus on the spy plot. That's
the spy
because
plot.
The time section is just a gimmick.
Not Monopoly. Yeah.
It's just a gimmick.
Okay.
Just focus on story.
So I'll give it a 7/10 right now. Yeah. Rasman, first time watching, what do you give it?
I think 6.
6/10, yeah. That was my first time watching.
Yeah.
I give it 6/10.
I'll give it a 7.5 this time around.
7.5, there you go.
Yeah.
So, you're right. So, I'll see you guys. Thanks so much. And thumbs up and
thumbs
subscribe,
up.
Please. All right. Thanks, guys. Bye.